How to wiggle your toes. In order for you to wiggle your toes, a message must travel from your brain down to your feet. That might sound simple, but it in fact required some remarkable events to have happened.
Little Piffle.
This is a story about you when you were very young, or more accurately, a very, very tiny part of you. Specifically, it's about a cell in your brain which we're going to call Betsy. Betsy is a brand new neuron, only a few hours old, and she's got a job to do. She has received chemical instructions which have activated a string of biological processes inside her, kind of like a robot receiving orders. Betsy is to be part of a team of cells that will carry messages from your brain all the way down your spine and deliver them to neurons that can then control the muscles in your arms and your legs. But in order for Betsy to be able to send messages all that way, she has to first grow a very long cable which can carry electrical signals, and this cable is called an axon. Amazingly, she manages this while a billion other neurons around her are growing their own axons to other places in your body. Understanding just how Betsy grows her axon so precisely over such a long distance is hugely important, so one day we might help people who have suffered from nerve damage, which is currently very difficult to repair. First, Betsy creates a growth cone from which extend small sticky fingers called filopodia. When these sticky fingers stick to the outsides of nearby cells, tiny muscle-like filaments within them contract, which pulls the growth cone forwards through your body, trailing the growing axon behind it. At the same time, Betsy is sending new material down to her growth cone along tiny microtubule tracks that run along the inside of her axon. These microtubule tracks continuously extend further into the growth cone and so push it forward from within. This is how Betsy's growth cone moves through your body and she grows her axon. The filopodia stick to nearby cells and pull the growth cone forwards, whilst microtubules push the growth cone forwards from within. But with so many possible paths to choose from, how does Betsy's growth cone determine in which direction to go? The material that Betsy sends down her axon to her growth cone includes tiny chemical sensors, similar to the ones found in your nose and your tongue. However, these sensors are not for food, but to detect special signaling proteins that either attract or repel the advancing growth cone. These signaling molecules do this by either stabilizing the microtubule tracts within the growth cone or collapsing them, and, in so doing, change the direction in which the microtubules push the cone from within, and so guide its growth. These signaling proteins can be found on the outer membranes of many cells, and so influence the growth cone when it makes contact, and are also released into the spaces between cells, and these affect the growth cone's direction from a distance. We're doing well now. Whilst others have gone off course, Betsy's growth cone has reached your brainstem at the base of your skull, and is now approaching the point where it has to cross over the midline of your body. Betsy lives in the right side of your brain and, therefore, will eventually control the toes on your left foot. Nobody quite knows why neurons on the right side of your brain need control muscles on the left side of your body, and vice versa, but it evolved ages ago, long before even lizards were around. So Betsy's growth cone crosses in your brainstem from right to left and then continues on down your spinal cord. Time is running out now. Betsy's growth cone has to reach its target soon, as we're now approaching a special stage in your development where any neuron whose axon has not reached its designated target will be instructed to begin apoptosis and will die. This is an important step so that your nervous system ends up wired correctly, because a poorly wired nervous system simply would not work very well. Betsy, however, is on course and is getting closer. Her growth cone detects the specific mix of signaling proteins being excreted by her designated target and begins to home in. The target is a motor neuron in your spine, which has, in this same time, grown its own axon from your spinal cord down to your tippy toes and connected to a muscle there. When Betsy finally makes contact, she receives an elixir from the motor neuron, which, when the clock hits zero, keeps her alive when all the neurons that did not reach their targets die. Right now, whilst you're watching this video, if you wiggle your fingers or toes, it is these successful Betsy cells in your brain's motor cortex that carry messages from your brain all the way down to the motor neurons in your spine, which then carry the signal to muscles in your hands and your feet, making them contract and your digits wiggle, all in just a fraction of a second. And the instructions to build this remarkable system and much, much more can all be found in your DNA, which I think is awesome. We already know an awful lot about how the brain works, but there is still so much more to learn. If you would like to know more about how the brain works today, you can visit BrainFacts.org and also subscribe to this channel for more fun videos. Thanks for watching!